What's that one? That one verse, not the whole rule, the commands, but that one verse.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work. Thou
stop.
No.
So this one is thou. You shouldn't do it.
Next one.
Thy son.
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, you've got, yeah, not your son.
So, Sheila, or you got it there? Your daughter.
Then you've got male servant.
Yeah.
And you've got female servant.
Maid or female.
Yeah. Not your cattle. Not your stranger.
Or aliens in the land. Yeah,
yeah, who is within your gates.
And that just happens to be...
seven.
It was like another seven in a seven, don't
yeah,
I?
Yeah, interesting.
I just think the Lord's like, yeah. Wow. That was one quickly. Then there's, yeah, I never knew that. Did you know that?
Yeah.
First time I learned that yesterday. You know, it is finished as the last one, but he says, you know, mother, son, and a couple of other ones, like, what I need to say to me. But the seven things he actually says on the cross after he's been pierced seven times. But anyway, Jeremiah, this came through Genesis. I'm on Genesis verse 121, after about 70 hours of Hebrew, across verse 21 of Genesis. But Jeremiah 32, I mentioned this point before, I think.
22:9.
Derek, or?
We did.
John, then. Jeremiah 32:9.
And I bought the field of Hananiel, my uncle's son, that was in Anathoth. Weigh him the money, even 17 shekels of silver.
Right, so my heading in here says Jeremiah being imprisoned by Zedekiah for his prophecy, buyeth Hananiah's field, Barak must preserve the evidence as token of the people's return. So he's bought this field for 17 shekels, knowing they got the Babylonian captivity, but they're going to be coming back. Okay? So that's confidence, isn't it? Jeremiah's prayer complains to God. God confirms the captivity for their sins and promises a gracious return. So he promises to bring them back. So that's 17. Quite often turns up, God gives out an order of 10 and it's replied with a 7. It's a 7 and a 10. And in some Hebrew it says he bought it with 7 shekels, or shekelim, and then 10 shekels. So it's a 7 and a 10. 7 and a 10. Because that's heavenly perfection, spiritual order, is it? Is that one?
Yeah.
Order. So it's a 7 and a 10. Now, that was what I understood years ago, well, a while back. But we were doing Genesis yesterday, and when God created the third day, the fourth day, at the end of it, he says, and it was good.
Yeah.
I don't know if someone wants to find a reference to that in Genesis. It's Genesis, but it's after the third day.
And so God saw that it was good.
And it was good. Now in Hebrew, good is tov. People say erev tov, good evening. Erev tov, good evening. Or boker tov, which is good morning. Boker tov. Or they'll say shalom tov, have a good year. Or
yeah.
So tov is like a greeting for good. But that tov is a tref, a vav. And a bet. I've learned as well this week, if it's got a little dot inside it, it means it's a B, A alpha, beta, gamma, you know, the A, B.
Yeah.
If it hasn't, it's a V. So it stays a V. If it's given a dot, it becomes a B. Because some people write like Al, and Ab, don't they? Abraham and Abraham. But it's all, that letter there can be a V or a B, depending on whether it's got a dot in it. Anyway, so that's tall. So to Psalm 119. Psalm 119.
Okay.
I don't think it's the only one he's got to do, but a few of them.
Aleph. Got Aleph, Beth, Gimel.
Yeah. So we've got the first one, because Hebrew goes that way. I should have written that. See, I leave that here on the English way. So the words of Teth is, what number letter is that? You've got Aleph, Beth, Gimel, Dalet. Counting them through, it begins verse 65. Oh, that's
verse 65.
Yeah. Yeah. What? But what number letter is it?
Oh,
Aleph being the first, then Beth.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
So every eight verses has a new letter. Aleph, Beth, Gimel, Dalet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. As John said, it's 9. Mm-hmm. So, Teth has a numerical value of 9.
Yeah, okay.
Vav is the one after
he. Oh, it's got the little, it's got the little squiggle next to it.
Man, has it got that?
It's got that, yeah. 9, okay.
Vav, 6. 6, yeah. And then this one, that. Is the second one Beth, but it's without the dot, so it's a Beth. What's the second letter in yours? Does it give it? 7.2 sometime.
Yeah.
So that's a 2, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's just, if anyone cares about that, 17. And what day did Jesus rise from the dead?
17th
of Iceland. Yeah, Tom, it was good. So, Teth, Vav, there. I should have written it the opposite way round, but going that way. Just thought that was a little pleasant. Well,
very interesting.
17 is part of 153.
It is 17 9, isn't it? Yeah, it's another one, yeah. 17 is big, it comes up a lot of times. Because it says in Hebrew, but it was 12, so 17 is good.